got to go.
No more film. You're done filming. I need to leave immediately. You took advantage of it.
Hey,
you have to go.
Fossil fuels, we got to go. Hey, hey. 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 Fossil fuels, we got to go. Hey, hey.
Fossil fuels, we got to go. Anywhere we out there,
show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like. Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like. Hey. Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like. Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Please exit the chamber. Out.
Back.
chamber, please, and down the steps. Back up, please, okay. To the steps. There's a step right there. Go to it, please.
Step down. Step down. Let this lady have some move. Step down. Step down. This is a secure area. We're telling you to move back.
By nonviolent civil resistance, by breaking the law, shutting down the machine over there, this is mass testing. You can raise the murder.
Down.
Nothing else is going to do the business. We're out of time. Professor David King. In Southeast Asia, it is now impossible
at all. If you want to do it, take it down there. Let my kids enjoy it in peace, please. That's all I'm asking. What are they saying? Do you hear?
Deadly temperatures are spreading across this country and across the world. Our food supply is in danger. The wheat harvest is
failing. Emergency!
Dude, we don't want to hear it.
We don't have a choice but to look at what we're facing dead in the face. We've avoided it for too long. We have too much on the line. And we cannot afford to lose.
This is the life that your children.
This is where history has been made time and time again. And we must stand here.
Do I have your children?
No action on the climate emergency.
Do you understand what I'm saying, sir? Don't step up here again. Do you understand?
We cannot ignore it anymore.
We want to ignore you and enjoy
this. There are too many people who are going to lose their lives. We must engage in sustained nonviolent civil disobedience. There is reams of data on what we are facing. How bad this problem is has been something more resolved than how real gravity is. It is a problem.
I'm glad you're letting my kids enjoy a fucking monument. This is ridiculous.
We must be disruptive.
Go there. Be disruptive somewhere else.
Sacrificial. We must display courage. And also, make sure that we will not be moved. We gotta let people know what's happening, where people are. If you're not ready to hear it, I'm sorry, but we need to hear it, we need to see it, and we need to take the action necessary.
Go there. Let our kids enjoy it.
We don't have the science to back it up to get out of here. I need papers.
Does somebody want to help me push him out of here so we can enjoy it?
No, here, now, with me, let's talk about it. Let's talk about it.
We can't be comfortable anymore while this is happening. We've been waiting for decades.
And I'm telling you, the people of this country have the power to bring this country peacefully and nonviolently to a halt. until our demand is met. The only thing that is missing is faith in your own power. We have to organize, we have to put into action what's going to work: nonviolent civil resistance. It needs peaceful, nonviolently bringing the function of government in Washington, D.C. to a halt until our demand is met. We are demanding that President Biden lift the pen off his desk, sign a declaration of climate emergency, begin taking emergency action to safeguard the future of this country.
Is this helping any cause that they're representing up here at all?
Yeah, you're just ruining it for the rest of the fucking country.
Will is also
stuck.
Yeah, looks like it.
You're not allowed to videotape up here, you know that, right?
I looked at the CFR already. It's...
Okay. We'll just step over there right now.
Okay. Hey, so we're just gonna come down the
side. Alright, that's fine, let's go.
Hey, watch out, man. Kill the way.
We gotta come around this side here.
You man, he's under the rat! You man, this is fucking
awesome! This way.
Everybody! Listen up!
The planet's on fire!
We must end oil now!
The planet's
now.
On fire!
We must
the
end
planet's
oil.
On fire! What are we gonna do?
Don't back up and fall! Don't back up and fall! That's your order! Do not fall!
The planet's on fire! The planet's on fire! The planet's on fire!
Straight to the park? Across
yeah, we can.
When Florida sinks in the ocean, then you're gonna know what freedom looks like.
So you gotta back up.
Stop running by emergency.
Thank you.
And oil now!
I'm not denying both ways, sir.
Back up there. Just keep getting in the way.
Watch your step.
Anybody else got a cane?
I mean,
no, we'll just transport him in.
I'm a two-man.
Yeah, that's fine.
You can, hey, buddy, you can be all right.
Yes, sir.
You can go. Just go down the wall, man. You're fine. Just go down the wall. You're fine. Just go down the wall. Good. I'm not gonna push it that far back. Just
jump,
right there.
Jump over here.
There you go. You're perfect. Right up there by the blue shirt. Right by my police car. Very good.
I'm
only thing that has a chance of success is mass civil resistance at this point. We don't have any time to speak up. And if people don't get out in the streets with us, we're not going to survive. And that's not hyperbole. That's the truth.
Save the planet, save your children and grandchildren and nature that we love. And so I just really encourage everyone to sign up with Declare Emergency, or if you're an old folk like me, Third Act is also working on the issue, as well as a bunch of other groups that I work with. And I, like Paul, I've tried everything. I've petitioned, I canvass, I work for candidates, I just do a lot of other things, but so far we've had no movement. So I just hope you guys can hear this. Thank you.
I've come here to stand against humanity's inaction to the possibility of our planet becoming uninhabitable. I like to say, hey, hey, ho, ho, fossil fuels have got to go.
Hey, hey,
ho, ho, fossil fuels have got to go. Hey, hey, ho, ho, fossil fuels have got to go. Hey, hey, ho, ho, fossil fuels got to go.
You may have all heard about the climate emergency, that the world is superheating faster than anybody expected. You may have also heard that the government is doing absolutely nothing about this. In fact, you may have heard that they're going for something called net zero, and net zero might not be so great. Well, yeah, what net zero means is that they want to increase carbon emissions in the atmosphere for 30 straight 4 years, actually increase the amount of carbon in the atmosphere. This is a major, major issue. And it's not going to go away by voting. This problem is not on the ballot. Yes, yes, vote for Democrats, vote blue, it's great. But you know what? Reducing carbon to net emissions sooner than 2050 is not on the ballot in any state or any jurisdiction. What we need to do right now is enter into civil resistance. We're out of options, we're out of time, and frankly, you know, a lot of us are out of patience.
Hi, my name is Monica Zazueta, and I'm 7 months pregnant. I was arrested yesterday because I was standing with all these fine activists here trying to get Biden to declare a climate emergency. I have another son who is 8 years old, his name's Aries, and I'm fighting for his future and my unborn baby's future. If we do nothing, we're all pretty much F-U-C-K-E-D. Okay, I don't want to say it, but I mean, we are. Like, there's scientists that are saying if we don't do anything, billions of people are going to die.
Hello, everyone. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
I said, can you hear me?
Yeah.
We're out here because our country's in crisis. My name is Guido Reichstadter. I'm a father. I'm 42 years old. I'm a math and physics graduate. And I'm here to tell you about the climate crisis. I'm gonna lay it out straight. If you're concerned about the climate crisis and you are not shutting down the highways, if you're not blocking roads, if you're not bringing the function of government in Washington, D.C. to a halt, you are pissing in the wind at this stage in the game. We are in the end game. We have 3 to 4 years to start getting this turned around. What the climate crisis means is the misery and death of thousands of millions of people, that's billions of people, across the global south, Latin America, Africa, Asia, India. What it means is the end of this country as a relatively free and prosperous nation. It means the end of the future for your children. I come from the city of Miami, Florida. Miami, Florida will inevitably be destroyed within my children's lifetime. That is written in stone. The heat that's already gone into the ocean is raising the sea levels, and nothing will stop it now. It's gonna be a string of violence. My children are gonna see it. Louisiana, New Orleans, it's gonna be gone. Hundreds of cities around the world will not survive our children. We're looking at the collapse of societies around the world. We're looking at the forced migration or the deaths through starvation and civil war of thousands of millions of people. We are out of time. For 30 years, since the first IPCC report told us everything we needed to know to act on climate change, we have had 30 years of voting, of lobbying, of emailing, of writing our representatives. We've had 30 years of polite marches. They have brought us to this point in history where we have reached polite and respectable, absolute, abject failure. Abject failure. If we want to stop failing, we need to learn what wins. And I'm going to tell you what wins for people around the world in the global south is civil resistance. It means nonviolently shutting down the capital city day after day after day after day until our demand for a livable future is met. I'm out here with Declare Emergency. You can visit them at www.declareemergency.org. They are here yesterday. They shut down the 495. 414 people were arrested because they know this is the truth. And they're willing to act like it. What we need is hundreds and thousands of people who know that it is the truth. We need you to step out of your comfort zone and begin acting like it. Because unless we begin blocking roads, unless we begin being disruptive, unless we begin doing the things we have not done for the last 30 years, we will continue to fail. And if we continue to fail for the next 30 years, that's it, folks. We're done. So please, look it up, www.declareemergency.org. Need you to do more than care. We need it. Your children need you. The people of the Global South need you. Your planet needs you. The next 1,000 generations need you to step out and enter civil resistance. It is not hard. It's really simple. These folks had never stepped in a roadway before. They got trained. They did it safely. They shut down the 495. I guarantee you, if you have 1,000 people to shut down the 495 every day for the next 2 weeks, President Biden will lift up that tent. We will declare a climate emergency, and we will begin getting emergency action on this crisis. Nothing else is going to do it. All right. That's all I got. Thank y'all.
There's a quote from a guy named Nelson Mandela. You don't know him, but basically he was put in prison for years and then he got out and he became president of the United States. Nobody ever thought that would happen.
South Africa.
I'm sorry, Nelson Mandela was president of South Africa. Now, Nelson Mandela has a quote. It goes basically, sometimes it falls upon a generation to be great. And there's a word in the middle of that quote. It falls upon a generation, all right? It's falling upon you. It's falling upon you. Your parents have failed you. Your grandparents have failed you. It is falling upon you to be great in this situation. And I want you to think about that. You have the power to save the world. I'm 43 years old. I was never arrested for civil disobedience until this year. Until this year, I was basically wasting my time. I thought I could save the world in a million different ways. The reality was I was not playing the game.
If you pretend to care about the lives of humanity, you must take emergency action now. You must enter nonviolent civil resistance now. If you are not stepping into roadways to shut down the highways around the city to demand emergency action from our president, you are pissing in the wind.
What I do need him to do is just turn around.
Nothing less than emergency action will get it done.
We don't allow sound to go into the chamber.
Civil disobedience.
So it doesn't matter who
what
crew it is or who it is. So he can have a megaphone and he can be out there, that's fine. And he can be anywhere below the white marble steps.
Young people, this is your planet.
That's okay as well. All I just need to do is to shift around. His sound has got to go that way. If he doesn't want it, if he doesn't want to do that, he can't use the megaphone.
If you want to live,
what are like the
consequences? You have to rise up.
Do you want to talk?
Non-violent.
You can either do it. You can either do that or stop. That's the consequence.
Power of mass, nonviolent civil resistance. How India wants independence.
Can we talk sideways?
Sideways is fine, not directly into the chamber.
Around the world, year after year.
So that is our law, that's part of the like
the
federal regulations. We just don't allow sound to go directly into the chamber because it reverberates, right? And that's a silent, reflective space for people to go in and reflect on whatever they need to reflect on there. So you are absolutely allowed to be out here. It's part of your First Amendment right to be here. Whatever you're talking about is perfectly fine. I'm not going to stop that. Don't care about that. What I need you to do is just shift that sound. All I'm asking you to do. I'm not asking you to turn it down. I'm not asking you to talk. All I'm doing is asking you to shift that sound around to a different angle. Is that something y'all can do?
Any questions from
you? You shut the 495 down.
I do have a question. So, you shut the streets of this city down. Civil disobedience.
Non-violently.
Would we be arrested if we were to stand there and continue to reject salvation?
I can't answer that question. It doesn't take long.
A few days,
I'm
a few weeks.
Office. It's my job to enforce the CFR and those permitting type rules. And so that's like the 21st Amendment. That is part of what I do. So it's just what I know. Okay. And so when I see something to this effect, that's the first thing that I do is just, you can be here. You know, this is definitely a First Amendment space. Almost the entire mall is a First Amendment space. The reason everything below the white marble steps and out is. And this way, that way, once you get us to Vietnam, you can't do it, but this way is okay. I just need you to shift that sound. So, I can't answer what happens next, but, like, that's what I'm asking you to do.
I'm going to have to relay this message to our activists.
That's fine.
Is there any information I'm giving about police will be on the way or anything like that?
No, I'm not going to call them.
Okay. Well, that makes it more difficult.
I know it's uncomfortable. It's uncomfortable for me.
But there's police here. There's police standing watching.
Okay.
I want to be back with my family.
Yeah, there's always police here. This is the Lincoln Memorial. We constantly have park police. It's always here. And there's always, it's always in the video surveillance.
But this is not normal time.
Yeah. Okay.
We haven't chosen the times, but the times have chosen us. The times have chosen each and every one of you to act. I want to leave you with a quote by Franz Fanon. He said, every generation must discover its mission, fulfill it, or betray it. Every generation must discover its mission, fulfill it, or betray it. Young people, your mission is clear. The only choice left. Will you enter civil resistance? Will you fulfill your mission or will you betray it?
And that's fine. For the visit and being here, this is a free place to visit, but you can't hand out your items in here.
Okay. You can put them away.
You can put them away. Yeah. Like, feel free to visit. Yeah. This is absolutely your public space as well. I just don't want you to hand out the items. If you cannot hand out the items, then
how far up outside we can?
Down below the white marble steps.